And this is the greatness of Islamic law and Islamic Sharia, that there are 11 levels of Islamic commandments. No other law in this world, no other law in this world possess this much expansion and extension and flexibility as Islam does. Not everything is fard, and not everything is haram. There is no just yes and no, or there is no just act of commission and prohibition, no. There are 11 grades. The original scientists, the jurists and a'imma of fiqh, they used, initially they mentioned 5 grades. Then in the later centuries they mentioned 7 grades. Hanafis and Shafi's and Malikis and Hamlis, all a'imma. Then they, as the science of jurisprudence developed, then they came up to 9 grades. Mostly 7 to 9. I have codified in my book, and I have made the 11 grades. This is the development of Islamic jurisprudence. But nobody did on his own. Everybody had the evidence of Quran and Sunnah. So I developed it to 11 grades in the same way as our a'imma developed from 5 to 9. Basing on the authority of the science of Quran and Sunnah. So there, this is a very big science. I have mention a full-fledged chapter in my book, Al-Hukmu Shari'i. I should mention the grades for you. And you see how beautiful sequence, beautiful order, beautiful balance has been created in Islamic Sharia. No system of law in the whole world can provide this beauty. On one way, there are acts of commissions, positive commandments. On other side are acts of omissions, negative commandments. These are awamir, these are nawahi. These are the things to do. On left side are the things to abstain from, not to do. Here are do's, here are don'ts. But a beautiful balance has been created. Even when there were five, even then there was the balance. Two, and fifth one, common. When the scholars and jurists and imams developed the science up to 7 grades, there was a balance, 3 on this side and 3 on grade this side, equal, and the 7th one common for both sides. When they developed it into 9, they made 4 there and 4 here, and the 9th one common. I have developed in the science of Islamic jurisprudence up to the 11 grades, the same way. So now I think nothing has left which can be placed in any of the grades. On this side is fard, that is mandatory, equal to mandatory on negative side, the force which is available in the fard, the negative force of the same strength, same sanguinity, same seriousness, same force is available to another act which should come at the same level as the fard is. On negative side, that is haram. So the force possessed by fard in commission, same strength and force is possessed by haram in act of omission. You understand what I am saying? Here is fard, here is haram. Yes, you may count it. 2. Then coming down towards positive things, under fard there is wajib. Wajib, that is imperative. There is a little difference between fard and wajib. I don't feel time, now time has gone, I can't explain further. On the other side, opposite to wajib, at the same level, there is makruh tahrimi, condemned, and haram was forbidden. Here is imperative, and makruh tahrimi is condemned. So this is, its level, wajib's level is lower than fard. Then there is Islamic science about how these commandments would be categorized. I have given a formula based on 16 principles, 16 jurisprudential principles, how these grades would be fixed. I have given this formula in my book. This is not available in the early books. This is not available in the early usul al-fiqh books. No. The basic jurisprudential modes and principles and how these would be adjusted and fixed in various places in various grades. Wajib, then makruh tahrimi. Then comes sunnat muakkada. A sunnah al muakkada. It is compulsory recommendation. Yeah, imperative recommendation, incumbent recommendation. Recommendation. Opposite to sunnat al muakkada comes isa'at. Disapproved. So the same strength which is possessed by an act of commission on right side, the same negative strength is possessed in the left side. And every positive and negative command comes on the equal stage. So as-sunnah al-muakkada, the imperative recommendation, equal to that on negative sides come al-isa'ah. That is disapproved. Under makruh tahrimi, the condemned one. Then comes as-sunnah al-sunnah ghayru muakkada. As-sunnah ghayru al-muakkada. This is directly recommendation. That was imperative, compulsory recommendation. This is directly recommendation, suggestive recommendation. And opposite to sunnah ghair muakkada, directly recommendation, comes makruh tanzihi, improper. Makruh tanzihi, improper. How many grades we have fixed up, mentioned up till now? Eight. Then the fifth on this side comes mustahab. Mustahab means commendable. An act which is commendable. If you do, you will be blessed and rewarded. If you don't do it, there is no sin. Opposite to mustahab, there is khilaful awla. Khilaful awla. It is known as uncommendable. Commendable and uncommendable. Now five grades are on this side, acts of commission, and five grades are on the left side, acts of omission, the having negative force of commandment. 10 and 11th is common between the two, that is mubah, which the whole day we have discussed about the single point mubah. This is one of the manifestations of the mercy of Islam. Mubah, mubah known as permissible, and it is given another name, indifferent. So it is indifferent whether you may act it on upon it or you may abstain from it. So it doesn't make any difference. But you can't declare anything which is mubah, you can't declare it haram or bid'ah or shirk or unlawful, because this is common. This is on your discretion. 10 things are not on your discretion. Overwhelming majority of the things and acts in this world, they come under the fall within the purview of mubah. And in hadith of Holy Prophet ﷺ, Holy Prophet said, he mentioned even your ornaments, your various items of decoration, items of beautification, wool, your silk for ladies, your dresses, your eatables, your vegetables, this and that. He mentioned many things. He said, all these things on which Quran, Sunnah, yani Allah is silent about, it means that he has left on your discretion. This is mubah. So anything in your life, in any society, where you don't find any prohibition or categorical article of prohibition, it means this is mubah. But you should be careful in checking and examining that whether any act of a commandment of prohibition does exist or not. You can't say just no easily. This is the you can say, the matter of deep examining the things. So this is the act of the right of the authorities. The authorities, those who have very, very deep understanding and very vast knowledge and observation of the things, of the Quran and Hadith only, they are authoritatively able to say, yes, there is no single evidence saying it haram or saying it halal, that's it. You need a lot, quite a lot of your years of your age to spend in understanding these things. Not everybody can say these things. So these are 11 grades. So this is the Islamic law. ranks of various acts and grades of various acts, which provides us with this merciful position of Islam and provides us the generosity of Islam in practicing the Sharia and the rahmah of Islam for the whole Muslim Ummah and for other people. Thank you very much. وَمَا عَلَيْنَا إِلَّا الْبَلَاغُ.